Now, what is a quick sort procedure? So we have to write quick sort and assume we have the index location A, P and R, where starting index location is P and ending index location is R. And then we have to do, if P is less than R, then we have to partition. So Q will be partition A, P and R, and then we have to call this function recursively again, quick sort A P Q minus 1, and then we have to call quick sort A Q plus 1 to R. Okay, so this completely is your quick sort procedure. So what happened in this case is, assume we are having this following array. There are some values and some index locations here. Assume the initial index location is P and the ending index location is R. Okay, and initially if P is less than R, that means if at least there's more than one element, in that case we have to do Q is equal to partition A, P, R. That means we are going to call partitioning procedure onto this array. And then in the partitioning procedure, initially we are going to assume this is the pivot element. And wherever or with whatever value this pivot element will be swapped, then we are going to call this quick sort in the lower half. And then we are going to call this quick sort in the upper half. Assume this pivot element will be swapped with this value. Okay. Then this value, this position will be returned by I, which will be stored by Q. So Q will be here. And again, we are going to call quick sort into this part and then quick sort into this part. Okay. So in the same, in both these parts, we are going to again repeat the same procedure. Fine. Now let us take an example to understand what this quick sort procedure is and how exactly this quick sort position is going to swap this array. Now let us understand this quick sort procedure here. So I'm going to make a recursive tree, which is going to tell what are the recursive calls which we made here. And for that, let me just number the lines. This is line number 1, this is line number 2, and this is line number 3. Okay. So assume we have the following array. We have the array like this, which is having 5 values, which is 4, 3, 5, 6, and assume we have the value which is again 5. Fine. So I believe it is fine, or let us take one more value here. So let me take 2 here and 3 here. That will be better, I guess. Fine. Now this is the array A. Index locations are, assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So I'm repeating this again. Whenever we are writing an algorithm, that means if we write an algorithm, in that case for simplicity we assume that index locations are starting from 1, but if we write a program, in that case we assume that index locations are starting from 0, because in case of algorithm we want to make it as simple as possible, and algorithms are programming language independent. Fine. So initially we are going to call quick sort on this array. So we are going to call quick sort A, P is 1 and R is 5. So we are going to call quick sort A 1 5, right? In that case, this if condition, if 1 is less than 5, yes, it will be executed. Then this condition is true. So we are going to execute the line number 1. In the line number 1 is going to find what is the value of Q. That means perform a partition on this, and from wherever this 3 will be swapped, please give us the index location of that position. Fine. So let us apply partitioning in this case. So in the case of partitioning, so what will happen here? So initially J will point here and I will be somewhere here. That means one location less than this, and we will be having a pivot element which will be here. Okay. Now compare 4 and 3. 4 is greater than 3, therefore nothing will happen. We are just going to increment the value of J. Now compare 2 and 3. 2 is less than 3. Hence, we are going to increment the value of I, and then we are going to increment the values pointed by I and j. So we are going to swap the values pointed by I and j. So what will happen? 2 will come here and 4 will come here. Okay, for simplicity, I'm just going to change these values, right? So what will happen? 2 will come here and then 4 will come here. Okay, so this is 4. Don't confuse it. This is 4. Fine. Again, we are going to increment the value of j. Now, this 5 is greater than 3, hence we are not going to do anything. Again, increment the value of j. Now, this 6 is greater than 3, we are not going to do anything. Again, increment the value of j. Now, if this value is less than or equal to the pivot value, hence we are going to swap the value, we are going to increment the value of I, and then we are going to swap it. Therefore, I will point here. And then we are going to swap the values pointed by j and I. Therefore, what will happen? Instead of 4, 3 will come here and 4 will come here. Fine. So after this, what is the value of I? The value of I is 2. Because the value of I is 2, therefore this q will get a value which will be 2. Fine. That means we have executed the line number 1. Now we are going to execute the line number 2. In case of line number 2, we are going to call quick sort a 1 comma 1 because it is a p q minus 1. So a 1 comma 1, the value of q is 2, therefore it will be 1. Fine. Now, because it is a recursive call, we have to execute this statement first before executing that one. So in this case, you can see if this is p and this is r, then p is not less than r. That means the first condition is failed. Again, we'll go back to the previous case and then we are going to make a call which is quick sort a q plus 1 to r. So we are going to make quick sort a 3 comma 5, right? So in this recursive call, again, we have to do a partitioning procedure here. Okay, so we are going to make a partition and then that partition going to return the value of q. Hence, we have to apply the partitioning procedure in this part. So we have this 3, 4 and 5. In the case of partitioning procedure, we have pivot which will be here. We'll be having j here and I here. Now this 4 is greater than 4, this 5 is greater than 4. Hence we are not going to do anything. We'll just increment the value of j. This 6 is greater than 4, hence we are not going to do anything. Just increment the value of j. Now this 4 is less than equal to 4, hence we are going to increment the value of I, and then we are going to swap these two values. Okay, so 4 will come here and 5 will come here, or more clearly, just 4 will come here and 5 will come here. Okay, and by the end the value of I will be 3, hence the value which q will be getting will be 3. Okay, after this quick sort is going to call the line number 2. Therefore, it is going to call perform quick sort on a 3 comma 2, that is q minus 1. But here p is not less than r, hence nothing will happen. Again, we will go back to the previous call and then we are going to call quick sort a 4 comma 5, that means q plus 1 to r. Okay, that means perform quick sort onto this part, that is 6 and 5. So if we perform quick sort on 6 and 5, then what will happen? Initially we have to do partitioning, so we have to find the value of q here again. So if we are doing partitioning, then pivot will be here, we'll be having j here and I here. Now this 6 is greater than 5, hence we are not going to do anything, just increment the value of j. Now this 5 is less than or equal to 5, hence increment the value of I and then swap these two values. Therefore, 5 will come here and 6 will come here. Okay, so the value of I will be 4, therefore q will be getting 4. Hence again, it is going to do a recursive call which will be quick sort a 4, this will be p comma q minus 1, that is 4 comma 3. But in this case, p is not less than r, hence we are not going to do anything. Again, we'll go back to the previous statement and we are going to call quick sort a q plus 1 to
R, that means 5, 5. Again, P is not less than R, therefore we'll go back to the previous case. This statement has executed all these three statements. Hence, we are going to go back to this. This also executed all these three statements, and this also executed all these three statements. So after these recursive calls, you can see the last element, or okay, after these recursive calls, you can easily see that this complete array is already sorted. Fine. So this is the quick sort procedure. Okay, if you do not understand this, just rewind the video and watch it again. I'm sure you will understand this one very easily. So let me take one more example, which will be the worst case for quick sort. So just initially before that, just try to understand what is the time complexity of quick sort. Okay. Now in case of quick sort, if you see the partitioning procedure, you can find out that the time complexity of partitioning procedure is order of n. Fine. And then what will be the time complexity of quick sort? So assume we are having the best case here. So we'll be having three cases: best case, worst case, and average case. Fine. So in case of best case, we assume that this quick sort, every time we are going to partition, then partition will be from the exact middle. What I mean to say is, so if you are applying quick sort on any array and you find out that there is a partition, right, and this partitioning will take order of n time, but if it is doing a partition and the partition is from the exact middle, then we have to apply quick sort in the lower half and we have to apply the quick sort in the upper half, and these lower and upper half will be equal. Okay, for simplicity we are going to assume, in case of best case, we are saying if we apply quick sort on the n data items, then time taken to sort n data items will be equal to time taken to sort the first half, that means the first n by 2 data items, plus time taken to sort the second half, that means the second n by 2 data items, plus time taken to do partitioning, which will be equal to time taken to sort n data items, which will be equal to 2 into time taken to sort n by 2 data items plus n. Okay, so this is a recursive relation. So let us just solve this recursive relation to find out what is the best case time complexity for quick sort.